back from the dead.
Okay, you have to prepare yourself to be jealous and amazed by what I'm about to show you. It is a skeleton unicorn purse. Yes, you heard it right. It is a skeletal unicorn purse. Is it the coolest thing ever? Like, ever. Is it awesome? Like, I just had to share it with you guys because you're the only one that will appreciate it. What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. So, I decided to tackle this controversial topic that everyone's wanting me to do some sort of a review, kind of research. And so I did. So, let's talk about Huff Paranormal's Wonder Box, Steve Huff, if you're familiar with who he is. And so I'm going to kind of talk about who I know him as, my opinion, and then the research of what we kind of figured out what it does. So Huff Paranormal, or Steve Huff, I didn't actually know who he was. And that is not to sound like a prima donna. I just have never heard of him before. I actually had to call a bunch of my paranormal producer friends and be like, have you guys heard of this person? And I have a bunch of YouTubers, you know, you guys that are telling me, hey, you know, what do you think of this and what's your opinion? And so I was like, I have no idea who this person is. And really, none of my producer friends knew who this was either. If you're not familiar with what the Wonder Box is, it has been featured, obviously, I think now for the second season, on Nick Groff and Katrina's show, Paranormal Lockdown. This is not at all. This has nothing to do with Paranormal Lockdown. This review or discussion has nothing to do with Nick Groff or Katrina, for that matter. This has to do strictly with my opinion of the Wonder Box and discussion behind the Wonder Box. That's it. So of course, it also started when, like, I go online every once in a while. I just make sure I've got all the, like, up-to-date, you know, ghost gear. Like, I'm always on top of it. And so I was like, oh my god, let's see if there's anything new that came out from, like, Bill Chappell, because he's an engineer. And then you have Gary Gawka, who designed the Melmeter, and everything in between. So I was, like, going on all the ghost stores. And when I researched, you know, just in Google paranormal equipment, this Wonder Box thing also popped up. I had no idea what it was. I haven't really watched that much Paranormal Lockdown, but I do remember seeing parts of it when I was watching the show. So I thought, oh man, you know what? I'm going to just go order one, and I'm gonna get one, and then I can use it and I can show you guys, you know, what it does. That was until I saw that it basically ranges from $899 all the way up to $1,899. And I think there's another one that just dropped that's like $1,999, as in $1,999. I better be getting like some sort of like gold-plated toilet that like will summon my family from another life if that's what I'm paying for. Why I used a toilet, I don't know. Not very nice. No, I wasn't going to uproot myself and just pay $899 for whatever a Wonder Box is. I will pay for it after I research it, because I just bought the SLS, as you guys know, which was like a $1,500 piece of equipment. But also the reason why it's so expensive is Bill Chappell created a software, it's a computer software, As you saw in my last video, when you actually record on the SLS, you can take all of that footage and drop it from the software right into your computer, and it is amazing. So you also get a tablet with it, you know, so I mean, it's more than just like the Xbox camera that comes with it. Plus he has rigged it where it's like beautiful and nice, and you get this case, and I love the SLS, and it was totally worth the almost $1,600 that I paid for it. So what's so great about the Huff Box or the Wonder Box? I need to know before I out someone $900 at minimum. Obviously the fancier version is like $1,900 to $2,000. And I'm assuming that's the better version because as you guys know, with like a Melmeter, they have two or three different stages of Melmeters. The most expensive has the antenna function. And if you don't have that, I mean, it's kind of pointless. It just becomes an expensive EMF meter. So of course I'm gonna want, you know, the Huff Box or the Wonder Box, that's the really expensive one. So what am I paying $2,000 for exactly? So first, I found some bad credentials on this Steve Huff guy. He's obviously gained some fame from Paranormal Lockdown. Good for him. I'm really glad because as a community in the paranormal, we should always support one another because it's not the biggest community. But I found out through several different people online that have written blogs or journal like discussions about this guy, apparently that he used to be like a photography / camera like guru, and he would buy or get cameras and then he would do reviews on these cameras because he's a photographer. And then what would happen is people that followed him on social media or YouTube started catching on that he kind of had the same exact thing to say in every single review. Like, oh, this camera's great. Oh, but this camera's great. And so is this camera's great and this camera's great. And so people started catching on and found out that he was not releasing, that he was getting paid, basically sponsored to review these cameras, and he had to give them positive reviews on the internet in order to get the paycheck back. And he also more than likely got a free camera because that's how sponsorships work. So right off the bat, from different sources, this guy seems to not have the best, you know, credibility as far as being honest from his past. I've watched several videos on other YouTubers and paranormal people that, you know, they're like, well, you're either pro Steve Huff or against Steve Huff. There's really no in between. And I've seen some people that say, you know, his past has nothing to do with it. Actually, that should have a lot to do with credibility of who you are. I've talked about this before. Credibility is very important in this industry. You're talking about science. You're talking about interacting with the other side. Possibly, potentially, you're interacting with people's family or friends or somebody that's really close and interactive, and you don't want to have like a bad credential history when you're trying to prove the existence of something that basically is still considered non-existent. Does that make sense? So okay, I'm just gonna like, let's just put that information about the camera reviews off to the side for a minute. So then I started going through some of the videos that were done on this, on him and him interacting with the other side. There's been a couple interviews that were done, like he claims that he interacted with Mark and Debbie Constantino. He claims that he interacted with Robin Williams, you know, as everybody knows him as the famous actor. And he's also claimed a lot of other things. And I mean, I understand if an entity comes through saying they are Deb and Mark or someone else for that matter. I just feel like it's very sensitive, especially what happened with these people and like Robin Williams. I feel like that's a really big claim to make in the paranormal. Maybe that's my skeptic side coming through saying, wait a minute, I don't know if that should be used. I feel like that may not be very fair to the family. Or what's the legitimacy behind it? How can we really prove it's someone of that higher standard? How can we really prove it's that person, you know, that was of, you know, like Robin Williams, this famous actor, or Mark and Debbie that are huge in the paranormal industry? I just feel like making claims like that can be very tricky. And I feel like you need to be sensitive to people, including their family, the paranormal community, when you're making claims like that. And I don't know how you really prove that that's infinite, that that is exactly what happened. And I just feel like it should have been dealt with a little bit more, you know, with grace, maybe. Don't just come out and be like, oh yeah, Debbie and Mark were at my house and I got to interact with them. It's kind of like, I mean, when someone says that to me, I'm kind of like, really? Like, I'm not sure, like, how much I believe someone that would say that. I have heard Chris Fleming and Patrick Burns discuss on Chris's, he has like a talk show, radio show thing, and I've heard them both talk about, you know, they have been able to connect with Mark and Debbie. But the thing that people don't realize is that Mark and Debbie were very close with that group of paranormal, you know, experts. Like, Zach obviously had him on his show a lot. Chris knew them very well. I actually got to know Mark and Debbie myself. And I don't know at what point why someone like that would come through to someone that they didn't know. So I just find it very odd. So it's weird how this reads, purchasing the Wonder Box on the website. It says something like, he never guarantees that it's going to work, that it's basically an ITC piece of equipment, that it needs some sort of a app to use with it, or a radio, or a PSB7, or an amplifier. It shouldn't ever be used alone, basically. But yet, it kind of contradicts itself, because it also says on the website that you don't need white noise in order to interact with the other side, and that is the point of making and developing this Wonder Box. So I'm kind of confused. On one side, you're saying that you don't need any white noise or anything to use, you know, the Wonder Box, but then on the other side, you're saying it should be used with enhanced audio, like an app, a radio, an amplifier, a PSB7. So I'm strangely confused by it. I did watch videos on, you know, how Steve Huff and others used the Wonder Box that actually purchased it. He basically titles it as an enhancer. It's basically, I hate to say this, but like a fancy speaker with an EMF pump and a speaker inside of it, okay, is basically what it appears to be. It has crystals on the top mixed with like copper wiring to kind of generate it. And there's some video I watched where apparently he can open a portal on top of the Wonder Box and either, I'm not sure, summon things or like call things to it or however it works. I think that's a big false claim. I don't like anybody, you know, claiming that they can open a portal using a device or guarantee people or tell people if you buy this, you know, there is a, you know, a function on it for you to be able to open this portal. I don't agree with that at all. I just can't help it. I've told you too in the past, I've had other people that have said, oh, you know, tell entities, I'm going to come back and cross you over, except they don't know how to cross people over. They can't guarantee it. And then they never go back to do it anyways. So I don't like false claims on either side. I don't like entities to be given false hopes and promises. And I don't think paranormal investigators should be given like guarantees or not guaranteed, whatever, that this, you know, piece of equipment can open this portal and help you communicate. I don't agree with that. Unless you're some sort of like a magician or a sorceress or something and you can open a portal, which I don't know any offhand. If you do, freaking have them hit me up. But other than that, I don't really know who can open a portal using a crystal and a device and the way it's built. So then, okay, then let's turn the spectrum on that, which is he had this interview that he did, and I can link it below so that you guys can see it. And in the interview, Mr. Huff says that, you know, this person says, well, how did you build it? Why did you build it this way? And he basically answers saying that the spirits told him how to build it and why to build it that way. Maybe I should use the Amy Allen crazy face. Man, I don't know. I don't know how you have and develop credibility behind saying that you have built this mechanism for the paranormal industry. You're saying that there's 20 parts inside of this Wonder Box. And within those 20 parts, you're saying that the cost of labor itself to build it is about $550 plus all the other parts. So that equals to be $2,000. I don't believe it. And here's why I don't believe that, okay? There's a guy I used to work with who's on a couple of my videos named Ty. In fact, I think he might even be watching my videos. Ty, if you're out there, if you're still building equipment, hit me up and you know I will freaking plug it for you because you're the shit. So let me tell you a little bit about Ty. Ty was a guy that worked with me, freaking genius dude. He was an engineer on his own. I watched him with my own eyes build Jacob's ladders. He has a mind of his own. He's one of those that can look at the blueprints of how something's built and he can build it right there. But here's how I know this wonder box cannot be costing $2,000. Ty could make a Jacob's ladder. In fact, I think I purchased the parts for him, even though I had no idea what I was buying, for about $10. So engineering parts themselves, unless you're using some sort of crazy mechanism like the way Bill Chappell does, or even Gary Gawka, he's got like, you know, what are those, like, I don't know if they're memory boards or, you know, circuit boards inside of it. Those aren't super expensive, but when you start getting all of the pieces, it can be, because it's almost like a computer composite that you're building. Ty could do this. He was awesome. He was so good at doing engineering. He was even working on building his own drone, like, the last time I saw him. So that's why I'm saying, Ty, if you're out there, I will totally tell everybody about you, because he does onesie things. Like, he'll build one, you know, really cool Jacob's ladder. It looks really professional, and then he'll sell it on eBay or whatever. So that's how I know there is no way this wonder box, when it's technically, you know, not something super inclined like a PSB7, even as a radio, it's still like $60 to $80. You know, this SLS camera that I purchased, which I know I have a couple of friends out there, you guys have talked to me that you bought the SLS. It is well worth the $1,500 to $1,600 because it is beautifully engineered by an engineer named Bill Chappell. This wonder box doesn't really look like the best piece of equipment, just aesthetically to the eye. It definitely looks like something that's built from home, but there's no way that you're gonna tell me that this wonder box is worth $2,000 when my SLS camera was worth less than that, and it's more high technology than this wonder box, which is considered, they say, you know, you do need an app, you do need a radio, you do need something to help it be enhanced, but then on the other hand, you don't need white noise for it. It doesn't make sense. So my goal was to find somebody that has purchased a wonder box, and I did find several. I found several people. I'm trying to get one of those people to do an interview with me. Wish me luck, fingers crossed. Basically what a couple of these people did, they are paranormal gurus like you and me. They purchased this wonder box, and what's scary is they spent the $1,500, $2,000, and they took the sucker apart. Oh, I would love to do that if I had a lousy $2,000 just hanging around. They took this wonder box apart, and what they found inside was shocking, according to several people. Basically inside, they found almost like tape players that will play forwards and backwards at different times. It's very sporadic. I'm not sure how it's powered. Maybe it has to be charged, I'm not sure. But basically what will happen is at one point when the tapes kind of cross each other, you'll happen to get a word or a phrase or even a sentence. And at some point, you can somehow relate it to what you're visually, you know, speaking about or asking questions in relation to. I don't know if this is true. I haven't seen this with my own eyes. I mean, I've seen pictures of people actually taking it apart. I've seen the discussions that people have taken it apart. They've seen the same thing on the inside. Now, there have been several generations of the Wonder Box that have been built. This may not be the newest generation that has been built. I don't understand, on the website where you purchase this Wonder Box, he does talk about that there's, you know, 20 different parts specifically, but he's never specific on what the parts are. The one thing that I love about Bill Chappell, because he is an actual engineer and a paranormal engineer at that, is on his website, he will discuss what it is you're buying. So you're not kind of dumbfounded or blinded by, why is this costing me $1,600? Or even the paranormal puck, for that matter, and it comes with casing and housing, it's like $400 or something, but what am I getting? What is this? And it connects with software to your phone. I think there's LED lights on it. I know there's crystals, there's copper wires, there's all kinds of other things. I have a really hard time wanting to spend $2,000 on something that he said spirits helped him build. I saw a new video that he's asking everyone to basically work with him on Arizona time and on this certain day and do a meditation. And while you're meditating at his time, Arizona time, while he's YouTubing live, you tell your loved ones in a meditation a phrase or a word and send them to his house, and basically he'll tell you what they said. So is he psychic? Is he saying he's psychic if he's communicating with them? Is he communicating just through the box? If there's tapes playing in there, that's not fair that it's not publicly being, you know, marketed the proper way that it should be for being sold for $2,000. There should be some freaking specifics on this thing and how it's engineered, why it's engineered that way, and how does a portal come on? If there's a portal on that thing, am I going to see a purple light beam me up? Because that's awesome, and I will pay the $2,000 if there's a purple light that beams up Scotty. So I don't know what's going on with this box, but I really wish that someone out there that's watching this would come forward. That I know there's been several of you that have torn this thing apart, that you've been willing to basically wait, you know, throw away $2,000. I admire you for being so hardcore in the paranormal industry to be willing to do that. But please, somebody come forward, you know, that I haven't just had to read about your, you know, detective work basically. And I would even hide your identity if that's what you want me to do. I would be willing to do that. But please, if someone's out there that has torn one of these apart, please email me or email my team and we will try to set up some sort of an interview with you. Would I buy the Wonder Box? Not for $2,000. Sorry, not for $2,000. I have no idea what's going on. I have no idea what it is. I have never used it personally. I've never held one. I've never been in its presence. So I can't totally call it out as being fraudulent or something, and I won't. But my opinion is, for $2,000, I need more specifics. And honestly, my other equipment that you guys probably own too, for that matter, the Melmeter, I think when I bought it and knew it was like $250. You know, we have some expensive gear. Paranormal people are willing to pay the money for it. Like I said, the paranormal puck was like $400. The SLS is $1,500. But I'm not just buying this from anybody. You know, the one thing that's wonderful about Gary Gawka and his credentials is that he made the Melmeter for his daughter Melanie when she died. So what the heck? Like, you know his background. He did it in purpose of contacting his loved one, and he built this piece of equipment to help other people contact their loved ones. And then you have, you know, freaking Bill Chappell, man. Like, how can you go wrong with Bill? Like, he knows his shit. He engineers stuff from scratch up. He's innovative. He is very forward in this industry for science-based stuff. And you can't argue with the man because he's got some really awesome shit. And the only way you would know that is if you own some of his equipment, which I do. And it's amazing, to be honest with you. So what would I do with the Wonder Box? No, I'm not buying it for $2,000. I'm sorry. It's not. They've also said that there's some sort of like a guitar amplifier or amp inside of it or something that causes those like weird echoes that you hear when it was on TV. I don't know, but I wish somebody would tell me what those 20 parts are and how much each of them cost and give me a list, because I need to know why it's $2,000, and if it's made out of gold, then fine, I'll buy it. Otherwise, I think that people are getting seriously ripped off by this, if you want my opinion. And like, I love people that come up with new inventions, so I'm not ragging on anybody for that. This community is small. We need to support each other. But I also think there needs to be some honesty when you're doing this, right? Like, I've talked about honesty in the paranormal groups, in paranormal lead investigators, in production companies, even in networks. I'm also talking about it in inventors. You have to be honest. Like, Ty, I would watch this dude build stuff from scratch, and he wouldn't charge $2,000 for this stuff. I mean, especially if you're an engineer and you're building things, you know where to get the parts for inexpensive. So, I don't know. Anyway, I support everybody. This is no haterade. This is just the research I've done, because I was gonna buy it to, you know, research and show you guys, but there was no way I was gonna buy it for $2,000. There's no way. I would buy a camera or a camera set or night vision or anything like that for $2,000. I would never buy something that says that it's enhanced by a radio or an app or a PSB7. There's no way. So you're basically telling me it's kind of a fancy speaker is what it is. It's a fancy amplifier or something, and it's not gonna work for my pocketbook for $2,000. and knowing me without having, you know, that how it's built and what it's built by, I'm gonna take it apart, which means that $2,000 is gone. What do you guys think about it? Have you researched it at all? I mean, it's out there. If you feel like you're bored, Google it. It's not like it was hard to find, you know, what I'm talking about. It's all out there on the internet. So what do you guys think? Did you buy one? If somebody bought one, tell me, like, maybe there is legitimacy behind it. That's not the point here. The price is the issue. And I think that it's screwing people. And I guess in a way, if you're on the fraudulent side of paranormal, which you know I've talked about 100 times with other paranormal investigators, with other shows in particular, with psychics, I guess that he's actually, you know, doing kind of a smart thing by charging people $2,000 for this. He's making some quick cash. And I mean, you know, from his credentials in the past, I mean, it may not be the best. It may not be the best. And, you know, to be honest with you guys, even if he were to send me a free one of these, I would never ever promote a $2,000 product like this to you guys. There is no way this is a $2,000 item. It's not fair. I would never promote something like this to the paranormal community strictly for the cost, because I know exactly what it's like to be a lead investigator and fund everything myself. I know what it's like to fund everything for the team. I know what it's like and the cost of buying equipment, especially when it's shit you need like night vision and a freaking SLS. So there's no way I would even promote this for $2,000. The cost needs to come down. If it's legitimate, it needs to be maybe $400 to $500 if it's legitimate, but I don't know if it's legitimate. That is my opinion on it. If you've bought one, let me know. Please give me a thumbs up on my video. Make sure that you've subscribed to my channel if you haven't already. Leave me good comments below. What do you guys think about it? Give me ideas for what you want to hear about next. Follow me on social media, and I will catch you guys next time. Hell yeah. Back from the dead.